What's up, Jacob? What's up, folks? Rival Flash? I don't know. I'm not gonna get my hopes up, but I'm definitely tuning in for that Nintendo Direct tomorrow morning. Just going in as blind and open-minded as possible, for sure. Xeno Productions, if you'd like me to draw a Kadget, do me a favor, in the instructions below, in the video description, if you pick up a ToxicSoul 77 plushie, and then send proof of purchase to kerberfer1111@gmail.com, I would be happy to draw a Kadget for you. Live on stream right here. Yeah, I have no particular hopes or desires or anything for the Direct, because, I do like to go in as blind as I can. I'm sure there will be some more Pikmin 4 stuff probably mixed in there. Nailed your job interview today. Congrats, Trevor. Very cool. Well, Trevor, if you're able to afford buying a plushie right now, I'd be happy to draw something for you on stream right here. There's also a discount code. So if you input ToxicSoul7715, you'll get 15% off on that plushie. Oh, yeah. I don't know about if we'll get news of Tears of the Kingdom DLC this soon, but probably some Pokemon DLC news. I gotta say, I was talking about this with some folks the other night. So there was this, you know, Mario RPG rumor kind of, you know, floating around and everything. And every time I'm always like, hold on, what's the source? What's the source on this? Give me a minute. There was a leaker that was saying something about, like, there's going to be, according to this leaker, there's going to be potentially a reveal of a new 2D Mario game and potentially a reveal of a remake of a Super Nintendo game. And I guess some people took that as, oh, it's going to be Mario RPG. But it's like, no, those are two different bullet points listed by the this leaker. I'm not getting my hopes up for anything in particular yet. Because even that leak could be false, too. That discount was just added as a thing, like, the other day, so it was very new. Because now, we only got to get her up to 100 plushies sold. So, she's already up to 77. So, only a few more, and we can help her get to that point, so... Dylan Q, yes, if you buy two plushies, I will still add a background character. This one was, like, this little guy right here was one that I just got yesterday, so you still got time. If you buy two plushies and send me proof of purchase to kerberfor1111@gmail.com, I will give you a background character. TOXICSOUL'S 77 going to be in the third Tome movie? I don't know. You'll have to watch and find out. Coming out in just a few weeks. About 2.5 weeks now before we have our big release. Funnily enough, TOXICSOUL'S birthday is going to be on the same day as the release of Tome Zetto's Resolution. She is TOXICSOUL 77, in fact, because she was born on July 7th. Which was also the day that the final episode of the Tome web series came out, back in 2015. So, that's why we're releasing it on that day, so it kind of timed out perfectly, huh? Saw my work in the as the bad guy in the Black Clover movie. Good acting. Thank you. Appreciate that, Stoner Stan. Worked very hard on that. As Conrad Leto. Pink llamas were in. Have you infiltrated the base? Thank you. Yeah, I've had quite a few Final Fantasy 14 characters. It's funny, I was going to say, even with the color scheme and stuff, she kind of reminds me of Kizuna a tiny little bit. And it's funny, because I think that there even was some Final Fantasy 11 influence on Ruri's design. Ruri being, of course, like the very first sort of incarnation of Kizuna. Shrimpy shrimp lolly. What's up? Kote, that's right. Yeah, I forgot what the cat people race is called. Yeah, all the Final Fantasy MMO races are all really cool. Yet another MMO that I've been invited to play with people, but I'm like, nah, I'm just gonna go off and make cartoons and video games about MMOs instead of actually playing them. This is Lamau. What's up, Celtic Guardian? I have not played Final Fantasy XIV. I know a lot of people who do. I know a lot of people that played, what's it called? Final Fantasy XI as well, way back in the day. Welcome, Night Fury. Sub Cartoon Gamer. Cartoon Gamer, you got any requests? Want to help out a fellow Canadian? Might, Robert, you might. Are you on mobile, Celtic Guardian? Of course you were thinking the same reference. You are the cartoon gamer, after all.
You are the cartoon gamer, after all.
Welcome, Switchy. Switchy, not Squitchy, excuse me. Switchy the console. Wow. They've grown sentient. Do I have a favorite dog breed? Ooh. Not a specific one, but I love big stupid doofy dogs. I love huskies. I love German shepherds. They're very good.
Mm-hmm.
YouTube, yes, I'm still here. Yes, I'm still here. Da 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 What's up, Duke? To 290. I'm a goon? I don't want to be a goon. I hate being a goon. 5 out of the 10 left.
Coolio.
Switchy, if you would like a background character based on that item shop, like or electronic shop kind of guy, if you buy 2 plushies, I will add that character literally right now. I'll throw him in and do him as a background character. So don't wait if you've got an idea, and here's your opportunity for it. Oh, Ain't Llamas, is this your character? Very cool. Welcome, Leaf Lady. Uh, Dragonfire, these are the ones that I have left. So if you want to get one in, it's your last opportunity. Ooh, Ben Bob, I want to see Elemental. I haven't gotten to see it yet. No spoilers. But how did you like it? Hey, John Knight. Watched the Dr. Stone Season 3, Episode 9. That's very cool. I think that was the most recent one that I watched. Can't remember. I don't know if Mr. Mangaka is going to be in this season, or if maybe he might be in Season 3, Part 2 or something. Because I know that they're doing another core of it or whatever. But I love that show very much. What's up, Mafo? Now, Mafo, I know you want a drawing request. Oh, you're going to Philly? Very cool. I haven't been out there in a long time. Thank you. Yeah, I used to, when I would go there, I would usually hang out with the guys from Continue Show. Welcome, Aqua Q. Hopefully, I'll get to meet Kira. Oh, at a con? Oh, very cool. Nice. Yeah, that makes sense. Hoping Zeno shows up a sack of anime. Man, Zeno Robinson, I don't know about that guy. It's not like he's like the fucking nicest dude ever or anything. This character alone might possibly be the most elaborate one that I've drawn of all of them. It's goddamn. Rabbit, goddammit, I'm not, they're not short stacks, they're just chibi-fied. The love of God. don't you project your fantasies. Not that there's anything wrong with liking short stacks, they're very cute, but misassigning these characters. Destiny Lord, Chris, one thing I wanted a clarification on, are the current Sonic voice actors tied to Studiopolis, or are they just freelance, and Studiopolis is just where the lines are recorded? You're right, yes. So all the voice, and this is generally how it works for, like, the majority of projects, is, Ben Bob, I ain't unpacking that one, and don't go looking it up, please. Most voice actors are just freelancers, and individual projects are, you know, different clients. So, like, in that case, Sega is the client, of course, for the Sonic the Hedgehog video games, and Studiopolis is where they are recorded. So Roger Craig Smith and Colleen O'Shaughnessy and all those folks, they go to Studiopolis to record at. They're not, like, under some kind of, like, you know, they're not, like, owned by Studiopolis. They're not, like, you know, Studiopolis isn't, like, a, what's it called? Like an agency or anything. It's just a recording facility that Sega, does the production through and everything, so. But, yeah. Rabbit, save your money! Buy a plushie! Don't super chat me today! No, 4Kids, same thing. 4Kids does... I'll tell you right now, that's a common misconception. You know, Ocean doesn't own Scott McNeil and all the Canadian voice actors. 4Kids doesn't own Dan Green or... Like, that. It doesn't work that way. The only, like, thing I can think of like that is if it's, like, a company and, like, you're a person that is on the payroll of a company and maybe you're like their go-to commercial guy and you get like a salary. But even then, I think that that's an extremely, extremely rare circumstance. You know, or like at Crunchyroll, if you're like a director and like, you know, you do, if you happen to also, which, you know, most of the, not all, but most of the voice directors at Crunchyroll are also voice actors. And, but that's because they're working as staff members, to do stuff as well, so. Thoughts on Ralph Bakshi? I haven't actually seen a whole lot of Bakshi's work before. I think that they're fine. I mean, you know, he's certainly, like, a legendary artist. But I don't find him, like, to be, like, this tremendous inspiration compared to other artists or anything. He certainly got his place in history. Yeah, that's the thing too. Yeah, even the voice directors that they hire for certain shows, yeah, they're not. Yeah, they just they do freelance contracts with, you know, places like Studiopolis and otherwise. Are there any voice actors that I truly admire or are inspired by? Actually, speaking of Roger Craig Smith, I'm a huge fan of his work. I love James Arnold Taylor. Justin Cook is pretty awesome. Tabitha St. Germain is amazing. Yeah, there's tons. They're all huge inspirations on me. Yeah, Danny Chambers signed with Dean Panaro. She's fantastic. I'm thrilled for her. Yeah, she's been doing some stuff out here, especially when the remote kind of work opened up a lot more. Yeah, she is tremendously fucking talented. Hey, Jaden. Welcome. Jaden, yes. So, I'm currently taking requests. I am trying to help a buddy of mine reach their goal of selling 100 plushies. So, in the video description, you can, and also in the pinned comment, if you buy one plushie, I will draw any one character that you want of your request. Or if you buy two, I will animate a background character like any of these here that I've done from almost 300 of these lovely people. And I will put it in the background of one of my upcoming animated projects. So if you'd like to get one, either a drawing or a background character, go ahead and pick up one of those plushies in the link below, and then shoot proof of purchase to kerberfer1111@gmail.com. with the request of whatever you'd like to be drawn, and I will happily do it right here on stream live. So. Those of you who are also worried about how expensive they are, you can also use the promo code TOXICSOUL7715 and you will get a 15% discount on it. Oh yeah, she's a great design, Star Minion. Thanks again for buying a couple plushies so I could do her. I do have nieces and nephews. I have several. I have a niece and a nephew with my half-brother, and I have a niece and a nephew with one of my half-sisters. My sister Allison, who is the voice of Splat from TOME 2011, actually has a son and a daughter, Ruby and Jonah. There we are. All right. Three left. She's a self-insert. Do you have the green hair as well? Oh god. Oops. No, none of them call me Uncle Curb. When they were very young, sometimes they called me Uncle Creditor. Oh, that's cool. I've never had the balls to, or the ovaries, or the, I've never had the courage, sorry, that's a stupid term to use, to dye my hair. I've thought about blue for a long time, but thank you. Did I ever have to animate in paper when I was in college? Yes, I did. Funny story about that. My first animation teacher, he's no longer with us, unfortunately. He was a great, great guy. His name was Doug Crane. And he worked on a whole bunch of classic, like, awesome animated stuff. He worked on Beavis and Butthead, and he worked on the 80s Ninja Turtles. He worked on the beautifully, beautifully animated Raggedy Ann and Andy movie, if any of you guys have ever seen that before. And if you haven't, please check it out, because it's fantastic. Great guy. He was kind of like, he reminded me a lot of Hank Hill. He was kind of like a New Yorker version of Hank Hill. It was very funny. I came into my first year at animation school with not an attitude, but like, you know, an air of confidence of like, yeah, you know, I've worked on some stuff. I know what I'm doing. And he's like, oh, okay, all right. How about I give you the most difficult? Okay, so we each of us in the class had an animation assignment where we each had to do a walk cycle of a character. There were all sorts of different characters to pick from and everything. And then what we had to do was, after we'd finished animating the walk cycle of that character, we had to animate them transforming into somebody else's character. So that it would basically, at the end, it would be this single giant loop where they would all kind of like transform like into each other, sort of one after another. And that was my very first on paper animation assignment, like with a, you know, light box and all, you know, the works and everything. It was crazy. And he gave me the most complicated character of all of them, which was this like Bo Peep kind of character. She had like crazy frills all over her dress and curls in her hair and just this very, very like hyper elaborate design. And I was like, oh god, what have I gotten myself into? So I did the best I could. It probably was not great, but I did the best I could. Hey, Chaos of Wind. And then after that, I'm like, all right, yeah, I have not that I didn't know I had plenty to learn, but it definitely shut me up in terms of like my air of confidence of like, all right, just go in as a clean slate, you know what I mean? So, and he was cool. He wasn't like a dick about it or anything. It was a very good sport, and he's like, eh, well, there you go. And I'm like, yep, I got a lot to learn, because that was a lot harder than I thought it was going to be. So. Which was my favorite, somebody asked earlier, what's my favorite battle network to stream? I don't know what was my absolute favorite, like, overall, necessarily. I mean, I just love getting to play, I know it's such a cheapo answer, but I love getting to play all of them, because they all had, like, fun stuff in their own way. Oh yeah, Don Bluth's like big crazy animation thing. Yeah, I heard about that. Yeah, if I could afford that, I would consider it, but... Favorite Battle Network battle music. Oh, man. Honestly, I can't... I don't think I have a specific one. Gun to my head, I would say the M1 Grand Prix battle theme from Battle Network 3. Of course you can gift it to somebody. Absolutely. Do you mean gift the plushie or gift the drawing? Either way, yes, absolutely. Collabs will I do someday? Ooh. That's a tough one. I don't know. Anyone who wants to. I'd love to do a proper one with, Kagi, with, Kagi, Jesus, I couldn't even go by that anymore. With, Alejandro as Sayu, that'd be fun. Future games I want to stream. I would like to play that update to Y2K when it comes out. That'd be fun. Zetto or Base EXE? Probably Base, if I had to guess. Hi, Tricky Game. Welcome. Hi to Brazil. Do we still do stuff on Newgrounds? Not really. The last thing I did on Newgrounds was make, like, a post update on, like, my Newgrounds page about Hard Reset. I think that was it. And that was basically at Mac's request, so... I guess you'll need to know the shipping address of whoever you're gifting it to, so. Yeah, bass would just beat the shit out of it. Because the thing is, if we're talking, like, in the cyber world, I mean, bass is infinitely fucking stronger. I have absolutely no ego about admitting that. Yeah, no, you'd have to know the address of the person you want to gift it to and have it sent to, so. Brazil.
Gemini tournament was where you developed a mini crush on Zetto.
Jesus.
I wanted as much as possible. It's funny, when we did the RPG, I wanted to make Zetto the most like irredeemable piece of shit ever. Because obviously in 2011, and even like to a certain extent in TTA, I tried to make him a somewhat redeemable character. Even if he's a little, you know, fucked up in the head, but like RPG, I was just like, no, I want him to be like just absolutely the most insufferable asshole, just as an experiment, and to know and to see that people will still like him despite that, because people are insane. And I was right. So
thank you, Tricky Game. If you would like a drawing, check out the instructions. Buy a plushie from a friend of mine, and I'll draw a character for you. Yes, Trevor, Kadget was definitely inspired, in part, by Gospel, for sure. As well as, I think it was Goshinki, who was a villain from Inuyasha, one of Naraku's incarnations that was in, like, an episode or two. Oh, is that slang, like, in the same way that, like, in Japan they use, like, www to signify that they're laughing? Yeah, that's an unfortunately
That's an unfortunate type of letter that was picked for that slang, if that's the case. Alright, two left. Unless anyone donates for one. Do a little promo tweet real quick. Yeah, Glorious Omni. I think I've met this gentleman at a convention before. Favorite Aqua Teen character? Oh god, I don't know. Do I think I'll license a Living Tombstone song for balancing? I'd like to. I'd have to figure out exactly which one. I haven't listened to like some of Yoav's more like recent music from some of the other some of the other albums that he's done in more recent years. I need to hit up Yoav just like in general. It's been a little while since we've hung out. This is definitely up there. This boss theme is one of my favorites from Battle Network for sure. Alright, so this final one is going to be 296. There will be a total of 296 new background characters that were donated just for A2Z. So, good lord. You know, what would be pretty rad, in my opinion... It would be pretty great, I think, if we could get to a solid 300. So if just four more people would buy some plushies, That would be pretty great. Just putting that out there. Thank you, Blackbird's Folly. Appreciate it. Glad you like how they turned out.
Na 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 na
makes 296. Thank you, Destiny Lord. Appreciate that. Toxic's in the chat. Well, you have this cute little dude. And the last few as well, I'll show you in a minute. Hold on. You have got this dude, 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 this dude. Last, I don't remember. I think these last, like, 8 or 9 you have to thank for buying 2 plushies each. So... big shout out to these fine folks. Alright, folks, so the opportunity is still open, but in the meantime, I'm going to show you guys a little something cool. Alright, so... pause the music here for a moment. So, this is the new intro, one of the new scenes that we're going to have mixed into Zetto's Resolution, the third and final A2Z movie. And I won't show everything of it just yet, but I'll show you what's relevant to y'all. So, these are some of the new crowd shots that you guys are going to see your characters in. We show some little glimpses of each of the different regions of Tome, and scatter a bunch of these different dudes kind of all around here in different places. Zetto is on his way somewhere. Another little classic Lavendera part here. These are a bunch of the recycled ones right here. And here's a shot. Now, I mentioned, if you guys might remember, when I first started doing the ones for this third and final movie, I was drawing a lot of them facing to the right in kind of a battle position. And in fact, that was for a very particular reason, because it would seem that the woods are under attack by a not-so-nice hacker. Ha ha. And perhaps some of you might recognize who this character is if you're familiar with TTA, or if you're familiar with a sort of gender-bent version of them in the Tome RPG that's spoken one-word sentences. So, little appearance by a character that never had a 2011 incarnation before. So, this is Torture, spelled T-O-R-C-H-U-R-E. Torture. And, this was a fun little opportunity to throw them in there, of course. So that's all I'll show for this. And further, this is another new scene. So in this section in particular, this is shortly before the time limit for people to log out of the game happens. So this is going to be a big crowd shot where our heroes are planning to infiltrate the debug headquarters. And this will be one last shot, which now I'm going to go ahead and take. Yes, okay, all of these onward. So I'm going to go ahead and place these guys into this new scene here and get them all situated. I am waiting for the audio of a certain someone before I can start editing and animating a little tiny bit of stuff in this shot. But the last things, currently, the last remaining things to do on the whole production at this point is, and I'll talk about this too, actually. Tomorrow, I am recording a song. That is one of the last remaining things that has to do with the production of this. I'll leave it at that. And I'm waiting to, obviously I needed to place all these characters in here as well. That was something I was holding off on. And I just need a certain recording for perhaps this character here. This is Moshin, spelled M-O-S-H-I-N, Moshin. And this character is another one that is based off of a TTA character that never got to be in 2011 previously. I made them a moderator, much like Chase Ace. So once I get that, everything will be ready to be edited together into the final cut. And then we will have our movie complete and on time for its July 7th release. So we are approaching launch time ever, ever closer, everybody. And I'm very excited to share all this with y'all. Been working super hard on this, and I really, really hope that you guys enjoyed it. So, start spreading all these guys out. Moshin is based on a character from TTA called DKS, who is like a kendo swordsman kind of thing. Hearing the cops going fucking crazy about something outside. Who was next to Ani Doug in one of the Tome A2Z episodes? That was a character based on Faxall, who is like the evil kind of shadow alpha character from season 3 of TTA. Go. All right. Move these guys up a little bit. Sweet. Okay. One other very little minor touch that I'll probably toss in there as well is I'm going to have... I'm gonna have a couple of these guys do like the little log out like beam animation. Oh, sorry, Cox. If you met this girl, sorry about that. Oops, hold on. Which one is she? Which one are you? 292. Okay. 292. Nope. You. There you go. Save. And save this. I'm probably going to have some of these dudes do like the log out beaming animation because they are being instructed to get out of the game as soon as possible. So. All right. No, Julian Prince, the stream has been going for 2.5 hours, so... Alrighty. Well, that's going to end it here. So, folks, if you could all do me a favor... Let me get the tweet, actually, that Mickey made real quick. It would mean the world to me, even if you can't afford to buy one yourself... please do me a favor and go ahead and retweet this tweet from ToxicSoul because I would love to be able to help her reach 100 plushies sold before these last 3 days. They gave her a little extension and the discount and everything. So it would mean the world to me. If those of you who don't know, Toxic has been doing a whole ton of
character design work and art for Tome in particular. She did our box art for the Tome RPG. She designed Smooch. She did some background artwork. She did some guest animation stuff. And she's also the lead character designer for Balancing Act, which I've shown off a little bit of that art before. So, yeah, it would mean the world to me to help her out in any way that you possibly can, if you, even just retweeting and spreading the word and showing it around, because she's had it rough as of late, and I know this would be a great, great, great win for her to have this plushie funded and stuff. So anything you can do at all, even just to spread the word, would be incredibly kind. And like I mentioned, it's also going to be her birthday on the release day of the final Tome A2Z movie on July 7th, hence the 77 in her screen name. So, but that said, this is probably the last little preview that I'm going to show for this third movie. So, hang tight for just 2.5 weeks. I've still got some work to do, as I mentioned. I've got recording to do tomorrow. I've got a recording that I'm waiting on from somebody for this character that you're seeing right here. And then I've got to watch through it and hope that there's not going to be any weird audio glitches or video things or anything at all. Whew. And I will mention, I will still take drawing requests. If any of you guys see the VOD of this later and you want to buy one, you want a background character for, because there's still a little bit of time left, you can if you would like. So, where is it? There you go. Yeah, I would super appreciate it. So, in the meantime, folks, all of you, everybody, good Lord, thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you for donating and helping to fund this last little fun Tome production, this last little hurrah of mine. It's been awesome. I really, really hope that you look forward to the finished product, because so far I'm pretty proud of it, and the new ending and everything. Yes, Mac, I did reopen it, and I'm still kind of keeping it open. I want to help get TOXICSOUL to 100 plushies sold so they can get funded and sent out to everybody. So like I said, I'm still taking drawing requests. If you buy one and you send me the proof of purchase, I will do a stream for you. I will do a drawing for you on stream or otherwise. And if you buy two, I will still make you a background character. I will still throw any last couple in. Like, come on, man. Like, it'd be so cool to do that. Having even 300 characters in there. So, otherwise, though, thank you, everybody, for joining. This was fantastic. I'm going to go and eat because I'm starving. So I'll catch you all on the next one, and have a lovely rest of your night, and look forward to Tome A2Z Zetto's Resolution coming July 7th. Very soon. All right, everybody. I'll catch you later.